destined to lay at some point in the future. And that point remains unknown to us, but it is known to God. On the last video, we talked about what happens to us after we die. And this is the most important subject that any of us could possibly think on or discuss. And, you know, when we think about it, it's true to say that there's no margin of error. We have to be absolutely sure about what our destiny is after we die. But today I want to think a little bit about where death originated. Why do we see so many tombstones around us? Why do we see death all around us? When we turn on the news, we hear of people dying in wars, people dying in hurricanes, people dying in famines. It's all around us, and I think that that's one of our major fears as human beings, is the fear of death. So where did death originate from? Well, the answer is found in the Bible, God's Word. In the book of Genesis, chapter 2, verse 17, it gives us the answer to the question, where did death originate? And when we read the passages in the book of Genesis and we get to 2:17, we realize that man originally was not meant to die. The Bible tells us when he was created, he lived in a perfect paradise. A paradise where there was no evil, not even a hint or a trace. And the book of Genesis repeats many times throughout the creation account that the things God made, he saw that they were good and he blessed them. And so man in his pristine state, in his original form, was not subject to death. So where did death come from? Well, when God created the garden, it was a perfect paradise, and God told man, he blessed him and said, of all the trees of the garden, you may freely eat. And there was one restriction. He said, of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, you shall not eat. And then what he said after that was vitally important. He said, for in the hour that you shall eat thereof, you shall surely die. And we know the story that follows, how that Adam and Eve ate of the fruit when they were enticed by the serpent, and they were expelled from the garden. And then shortly after that, we read of their sons, Cain and Abel. And the first death recorded in the Bible was a murder. Cain murdered his brother Abel. And then when we get to Genesis chapter 6, we have the story of Noah, and the whole world was wiped out in a flood. God's divine judgment on mankind. And why did God judge the world at that time? Because he said that the imagination of their heart and their actions were continually evil. There was uninterrupted evil in the world, and so God destroyed the world in the flood and brought judgment. So there's a couple verses in the New Testament too that reiterate this, that God judges man with death. And the first one is found in Romans 3:23, and it tells us, for the wages of sin is death. Or excuse me, that's Romans 6:23, for the wages of sin is death. The payment for our sins is death. That's God's executed judgment in this world. And then the Bible tells us in Romans 3:23, that all have sinned. It's a universal human condition that all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. So sin originated in the Garden of Eden with the federal head of the human race, Adam, the Son of God. And so sin and death continued throughout every generation over thousands of years to this very point, where the book of Romans tells us that the wages of sin is death, and there's no one excluded, not one person. For all, even what we might consider the most morally upright person, all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. So it brings us back again to that original question. We can't deny the reality of death. We understand its origins. So now what happens to us after we die? We have to have a sure answer. There's no margin for error on this issue. So I want you to ponder these things. Think them over seriously. And do you have certainty in your life? Are you feeling reassured and comfortable about going to your place of rest? And what will be your lot after you awaken? Will it be a blessing or will it be a curse? We'll continue to discuss this subject further in our next video.